Hello people, so we are back with our new tutorial. This is lecture number 4, and in this lecture we are going to discuss something new. Up to 3 lectures we had been discussing only dollar scope, and dollar scope is used to define a variable, and that variable will be accessible within a controller. But what if we want a variable to be accessed in multiple controllers, and some situations may be there. For example, I can show you a situation where we may be willing to access one variable in multiple controllers. Like, suppose there are three pages in your application. First one is registration. Second one is login. Third one is anything you can take, like writing skills or something, anything, doesn't matter. Now, it may be possible that we are not willing to give every member, every logged in member, some role or some permission. Similarly, in login page also, it may be possible that after login, we are not willing to give some authority to that person. So in this case, what we do is we create a variable with something with name, something like logged in user, and we store the name of the person who has logged in. Name of the person, it means ID of the person. Generally, people log in with their ID of the person. So now what we will do, we will access this logged in user into all these three pages. And then we will, on the basis of the value that we are getting here, we define the permission or authority or role, whatever we want to give to that user. So in this case, so logged in user becomes a very important factor in all these three, HTML page. And it needs to be shared among all these three. So in AngularJS, var and dollar scope is not according to our requirement. It declares only variable within the controller, and that variable cannot be accessed outside the controller. So in this tutorial, our main motive is to define a variable that can be accessed from one controller to another controller. In AngularJS, to do that, we have another directive. Like dollar scope, we have another directive that is called root scope, something like dollar root in small and s caps and scope variable. This directive we can use in AngularJS to define any variable, and that variable can be accessed within multiple controllers. So let's see how it works. First of all, let's paste our Google API URL so that AngularJS script, whatever we will write, will be readable. It will not say that I don't know what you are writing. Let's create one script tag, and let's define our parent directive ng app equals to my controller. Okay, sorry, my app, some other name. Now let us define two controllers. The first one is ng controller equals to my controller one. See, we are taking in this example only two controllers, but there may be multiple controllers, but the concept of accessing any variable throughout the controller will be same. So you can take 2, 3, 4, whatever you want. So in the lecture we are taking 2 for practice. You yourself take 4, 5 controllers and try to access any variable among all of them. So let's define our second controller. MyCtrl2. So we have created our first controller, we have created our second controller. Now let us create the body for both the controllers in a script. So that is where app equals to angular.module and my app, our parent directive name, and then opening and closing big braces, app.controller, that is the way of writing controllers, and the name of the controller, that is my controller one, and comma one function we will have to create, and this function will accept each and every definitions conditions for that particular controller, and here that controller is my controller one. So let us take both this time dollar scope as well as dollar root scope, because I want to define both types of variable so that I can show you the visibility of the variables defined using dollar scope and dollar root scope. So what will be the difference between the visibility if we define a variable with dollar scope and if we define a variable with dollar root scope? So here let's define one variable where CTRL1, so that we can understand that this variable has been defined using dollar scope in controller 1, and some string IAM dollar scope defined inside controller 1, so that even message will be very clear to us. Let us create another variable, and this time we will use dollar root scope dot where CTRL1, and some, since one variable is already lying, so let us give some other name, one variable controllers, we put some a little different name, okay, and we define it, and let's give some value to this object, that is IAM dollar root scope defined in controller one. Similarly, we will create one more body for another controller, that is app.controller my controller 2 comma function and opening and closing braces. Again the same way, we will pass both dollar scope and dollar root scope. In this also we will be defining one variable with dollar scope and another with dollar root scope. So dollar scope dot where CTRL 2 equals to IAM defined in inside controller 2. So that, see, we are putting meaningful message so that we can while showing these variables on user interface, that is UI, we can understand with the message that this variable was defined in controller 1 and this variable was defined in controller 2. So now dollar scope dollar root scope, this time since we want to access variable of this controller into this controller and vice versa can also be possible, so let us define some v where CTRLS2, this is the naming we are putting similar so that we can understand, equals to, and let's store the value of this variable into this variable into second controller. If you are not understanding, let me explain this. See, if this variable, this root scope is accessible in second controller, then only this variable can be printed and will be shown, otherwise it will come blank. And if it is not accessible, then when we will print this on UI in second controller, it will come backend. So let us now see. So what we have done, we have defined two scope variables in controller 1, controller 2. We are defining dollar root scope, one root scope variable in controller 1 and one root scope variable in controller 2, and we are copying the variable, means overall we are loading the value of this variable into this variable, correct? Let us now print and see the difference. So first we put the message that is opening and closing double curly braces, and let us not print this, actually let us print this because obviously this is defined in this controller, and if we print it, obviously that will print. But we want to learn something new in this lecture, because we had been learning this from the old time, that whatever we define in a controller will be accessible on UI using dollar scope and dollar root scope both. But the difference in this lecture is, in this lecture we are going to access a variable from one controller into another controller, and here we are doing this. Now let's go to second controller and let us print this. Obviously this will be printed, and let us print this also. And the last one, the new variable we have created, I have done a mistake. If you have understood that, okay, then okay, otherwise I will show you what mistake I have done. So let us define this variable here. See, for showing a variable's value, we are not required to put the dollar scope. Simply, the name of the variable we will have to pass. So let us remove all these. So now our UI is ready with all the variables that we have defined in both the controllers. Now, according to whatever we have learned, this variable has been defined in my controller one only. So this should print. This variable has been defined in second controller, but we are trying to access it in first controller, but that is dollar scope, so this shouldn't print. Okay, br tag also let's put so that there will be clarity in the lines. Okay, and always remember two divs always come in new lines, so we are not required to put any br tag here. Now, so we are done with this very thing. Now see the second controller. This variable has been defined inside second controller using dollar scope. It means that this should print. This variable has been defined in controller 1 and using dollar scope, so this shouldn't print. And this variable we have created by ourselves using dollar root scope by using the root scope value of this. This, don't put this root scope, put this scope only, because we cannot directly print the value of root scope anywhere. Let it be, don't change, because root scope can also be printed anywhere. I'm really sorry, I forgot that. So now let us run this program and see the output, that what output is coming now. Let me take one snip of this so that we can see clearly in the same window, otherwise we will have to switch between all the windows. So now see, this variable is printing because this has been defined inside my controller 1. This variable is not printing because this is dollar scope defined in controller 2, but we are trying to access it in controller 1. Now second, where control, now CTRL2, as we had told, that will print. Okay, so it is printing here. Now we are trying to access a scope variable defined in controller 1 in controller 2, so that is not possible. So this is coming backend, and this was the main topic of our lecture today. Now dollar root scope, if we have defined some variable by after using dollar root scope, then it will be accessible inside this controller, and it is happening right now. Because see, this variable is printing here, correct, and this is coming from first controller. So friends, in the same way, if you want to make any variable common to all the controllers, define that variable using dollar root scope. I hope you have understood this lecture very well. I tried my best to explain. In next lecture, we will play with new topic. See, it may be possible that some of you may be thinking that I am just explaining in one page, I am not using multiple pages. Then let me tell you, I don't want to go very fast. If you want, I can explain one complete application, but there is no use unless you know the small elements of an application. Before making house, first you should collect wood, you should collect all the necessary items, then you should start making house. So whatever I am teaching you, please learn that small components I am explaining to you. You will have to understand that, you will have to learn that, and then we will start making good applications using AngularJS. So just keep following us on YouTube, and please, it's my humble request, please like us, subscribe us, share to your friends whoever is interested in learning AngularJS. We are putting our best effort to explain AngularJS to you. See you in next tutorial. Bye bye.